Hello and welcome to my presentation collaboration instead of competition, the Linux Distribution Working Group at the Open Mainframe Project. I'm Sarah Julia Kriesch. I'm an OpenSUSE member since around 10 years. I wrote my bachelor thesis at IBM and I'm a former IBMer founding the Linux Distribution Working Group that we are collaborating with other Linux distributions. The agenda is, firstly, I will tell something about myself. Then you are receiving a short introduction, what are mainframes? Most of you didn't touch as such hardware until now, so you should know what it is, and you should receive an overview. Then we are coming to the topic, the Open Mainframe Project. From that, we are coming to the foundation of the Linux Distribution Working Group with our goals and our reasons for our working group. Then I will tell something about collaboration versus competition, what has happened in the last year in this direction. Then we are coming to the topic, the benefits of collaboration, and we are coming to the Q&A session. Firstly, about myself, as I said, I'm an OpenSUSE contributor since around 10 years. I'm also a member of a release engineering team, and I'm responsible for the S390X architecture there. I'm also the team lead for our S390X team. I wrote my bachelor thesis at IBM, and now I'm a DevOps consultant and an open source contributor as part of my job at Accenture. Additionally, I am one of the founders of the Linux Distribution Working Group at the end of the last year. Mainframes are large high-performance computer systems. Default, you are calling them also big endian systems. If you are receiving any error messages, not supported for big endian, and mainframes are meant with that. The architecture for mainframes is the S390X architecture. IBM is providing the mainframe as a C system, system and a Linux One system. Linux One has got a special configuration for Linux with a difference to C systems, which is also supporting other C-specific operating systems. Mostly this architecture is also used for mission-critical data, so banks and automotive industry, as an example, are using such systems, and you can run thousands of VMs on such a system. IBM has founded the Open Mainframe Project in the year 2015 with the goal to provide also open hardware. The focal point of this open source project has been the deployment and the usage of Linux and open source in a mainframe computing environment. And this project is under the Linux Foundation. This open mainframe project has got mainframe-centric project under the hood. One is the SOVI, that is a mainframe, that is a framework for administrative development, test, and operation tasks on COS. AD is an anomaly detection engine for Linux logs. So it can detect anonymous time slices and messages. Geneva ERS is really new. That is a single pass optimization engine for data extraction. Ambitious should foster a community that will help educate developers about all open source technologies on COS and Linux on C. So that is an education projects. Sorrow is a COS open repository for workflows with a focus on COSMF workflows. Phi Long is an project for open source CVM Cloud Connector project. Tessia is a project for for faster starting of VMs in a mainframe environment that has been open sourced in the last year by IBM. Vanware is a software discovery tool. And Atom is responsible for language syntax highlighting for CVM. Then the Open Mainframe project is providing also mentoring. So you can receive also mentoring by different sponsors of the Open Mainframe project equal to Google Summer of Code. And then they have got also a COBOL programming course for free. Besides of all these sub-projects, the Open Mainframe project has got also some working groups where we have jumped on as a Linux distribution working group. But firstly, one of the working groups is the COBOL working group, and then the Open COS enablement working group exists. Last year at the IBM C-Day, they gave a talk and said there is a Debian working group, and we said, why only the Debian working group? We want to have one Linux distribution working group for all. So we had a kickoff meeting with all important community distributions at IBM. I met Elisabeth from IBM. She is responsible for the infrastructure for open source communities, and she's also an Ubuntu member besides her job. And we said, let's go to Debian and Fedora, that they join also. And we said we want to have representatives for every Linux distribution. So we had a kickoff with Dan from Fedora and Rajendra from Debian. And we started our Linux distribution working group with them. Now, one Linux distribution after the next one has joined. Firstly, SUSE, as our sponsor, has joined. Then we have integrated Ubuntu because of some Debian-based problems. Alpine is receiving support with us. And in the last months, also Rocky Linux and Alma Linux have joined. We are open for all Linux distributions who want to run an S390X port, so every Linux distribution can join now. Our structure is we are the founders, and with that also the leaders, Elisabeth and I. Our sponsor is Mark Post from SUSE. Therefore, SUSE is also available during our meetings every time. And yes, our goal and structure is that we have got a representative for the input by every Linux distribution joining us. We had some goals with that. In the last year, there were some problems with the support from IBM side for S390X specific bugs, and then we said we want to have a place for collaboration across Linux distributions, one with via the open mainframe project mailing list, a wiki, and the chat. So we want to provide a space for distributions to request for help on their port, and that we can collaborate and become a little bit innovative on this way also. Then what should be also sure was that we are receiving all required infrastructure for development and for testing that we can support our ports continuously, that should be safe and also for the future. And yes, my goal, I have added it at the end, was better support from IBM to fix S390X specific bugs. That is solved now also with the support on distinguished engineer level and CTO level now. the reasons and the background of that is I have got some experience at IBM in the Linux on C department from my bachelor phases and a little bit afterwards. And IBM is handling every Linux distribution separately. That I had the opinion that should have been changed a little bit. They should handle as equal. And I have seen community distributions have run into the same issues. Now we have got also the situation enterprise distributions run into the same issues also, but now we found solutions for that. And then I had managers who have called us competitors. So I wanted to have that the Linux distribution should show we can collaborate and we are partners and we want to have equality with that. That is the C Linux collaboration of the last year. IBM has supported mostly Red Hat, SUSE, and Ubuntu as enterprise distributions. And then we had our community distributions, Fedora, OpenSUSE, and Debian. Everybody knows OpenSUSE is the foundation for SLES, the same as Red Hat is using Fedora as a foundation, and Ubuntu is using Debian as a foundation. But then we have got also the relationship between the community distributions. Why shouldn't you contribute to multiple Linux distributions as a community member? On this way, we have got also Fedora as our partner at this conference. We are collaborating with them. And on this way, we said also for our Linux distribution working group, we can also collaborate together and support other Linux distributions with knowledge sharing and everything else in such a Linux distribution working group. Then IBM is providing also support with hardware and VMs in the Linux One Community Cloud or the Linux One Open Source Software Community Cloud. That is all sponsored by IBM. You can receive free access for 120 days for a single open for single open source contributors. That is in the Linux One Community Cloud, or you can receive long-term access for open source projects in the Linux One Open Source Software Community Cloud. In our case, OpenSUSE has got 7 VMs for the Linux One Open Source Software Community Cloud, and we are using it for packaging, testing of new software, everything in this direction. Our contact person for long-term access is Elisabeth. She is visiting also our meetings continuously, and where we can speak with her all the time. Then I want to come to an example bug of the last year where every Linux distribution has run into it. We have reported it upstream at LLVM because that was a compiler error, and IBM said when we do not fix that, that should be fixed by application communities. We asked us then, okay, let's speak with the PostgreSQL community whether there is a patch available or anything in this direction. And when I asked the product owner in the compiler team at IBM how we should fix that, and then there was the hint that is a temporary problem that will be self-healing if all distributions were built with C13. The crazy case was that we had a C13 at SUSE for building stuff, and it did not work. So I had a small discussion with him, and then I have received the correct keywords for the Google search, and then we found a patch which wasn't integrated in PostgreSQL upstream. And so we have received it running with PostgreSQL version. But Debian had the same issue then, and this year Ubuntu came also with this issue, and we have forwarded our solution then. Ben, we had also a discussion on at LLVM with PostgreSQL developers, and they were a little bit surprised. Okay, that is, they are integrating it as fast as possible because of this bug. From that our bugs were not fixed in the last year, we are coming to the statements from my managers at IBM. As I said at the beginning, we were called competitors, yes, but there were also some restrictions. Don't contribute upstream. Other Linux distributions may have a benefit of that. I found that a little bit crazy, and when I wanted to change it a little bit, our collaboration thinking in the Linux distribution working group is contribute upstream. Other Linux distributions may have a benefit of that. That is collaboration thinking, that we can support the others via upstream contributions and that we share knowledge as we are doing it at this conference between all of us. Such a collaboration is a benefit. Upstream contributions are available for all then. You are receiving a lowering of research and development costs. You are sharing your knowledge. Everybody has got it available. And that is not only for IBM, that is also in the community. And on this way, you don't have to separate all the Linux distributions. You have got one point of contact, and the topics are available mostly for all Linux distributions. On this way, we have got also the same solutions for all Linux distributions on the C systems architecture. We are sharing the knowledge between communities. And if we don't have so many issues anymore, we can also increase innovation with diverse community ideas. And on this way, you can also accelerating Linux development for S390X. We have got also benefits of cross-community members. If you are sharing your knowledge, you can become more and more also cross-community members. And yes, as we are seeing that at this conference, we have got a better communication between communities. You are visible, you are creating trust with partnerships between distributions. You have got more transparency, who is doing what is happening in upstream projects, what is the solution for problems in other Linux distributions. And yes, as we are doing it here, we are sharing our knowledge also at conferences. From that, we are coming to the results of this open cross-collaboration. We can achieve a better performance. Where are we now? We have got a cooperative behavior now with one approach for all. The distinguished engineer is reviewing our solutions, what can we do better and everything else. We are sharing our work and our solution, and we are open. From this open behavior, we are coming also to the heterogeneity of the participants. We are from everywhere on the world. We are coming from different Linux distributions, and with that, we have got a diversity, and we are creating a cooperation as interaction, and that is also life-giving if we are doing the maintenance stuff together. And so we are also achieving a better performance for all S390X ports. If you have got the time, you can come also to the innovation topic. In the last meeting, we didn't have any issues anymore, so I thought about innovation stuff, and we can have different views on the mainframe and what you can do in the future. We are creating open access to contribute to the S390X topic. Interaction and exchange is created with our monthly meetings. Everybody can integrate new ideas. At the end, you are creating with such a behavior also economic values for all. We have got a better development experience now, and this topic, open collaboration for innovation, is based also on a research paper, Open Collaboration for Innovation, Principles and Performance, and yes, you have got a collective intelligence at the end. We are bringing communities and companies on this way also together. Every enterprise distribution is allowed to join. IBM has joined. So we are creating an inclusive environment. We do not want to exclude any Linux distribution. Every Linux distribution is allowed to join. We are growing continuously. We are creating an open source diversity on this way, and we are also open for more ideas how to improve this environment. And then we are coming to the topic how to join us. We have got a wiki page where we are describing how you can join us. You should subscribe our mailing list, our meeting invitements are posted there. If you want to join our monthly meetings with the exchange sessions, but in the wiki we have got also all about our last meetings, how we have fixed any issues or anything else, and how our discussions have resulted. And yes, we are writing also on which conferences we want to speak and everything else. So if you want to join as a contributor, you can join us. Have we got any questions in this direction? It seems we are in time.
We can go over a bit, but you'll answer. I have a question.
Yes. Should I come?
Oh no, I can just, if you can hear me, unless we want to record it. Is there an open hardware standard that IBM has? You said there was open standards for S390X from IBM. Is there hardware as well?
This open mainframe project has been founded by IBM with the goal to provide open hardware. And most in this direction, like firmware development and in this direction should be public now, but not all. Last meeting, I have suggested some CPU improvement as an example, but the distinguished engineer is saying, "When stop, you can suggest, but we have to collaborate then." So completely open, it is not. They have got the goal to become open source, but you need a collaboration together in this direction. You can contribute via the mentorship program in this direction and everything else, but in general, that is a mixture at the moment. So one part is open, you don't know which part. There is the open mainframe project. You can receive access to hardware for free via the open mainframe project. But in the background, IBM is saying not all is public at the moment. That is a step-by-step process.
And is there training for people new to S390X Z systems on the OMP?
Yes. There is something. There is the C Explore program. Does the internet want to work? C Explore is a free education program by IBM. In the past, it has been called Master the Mainframe. Now they are calling that C Explore. It seems the internet does not want to do as fast as I want to have. Oops. Ah, here it is. They are providing it all. So under C-Education, you are receiving a foundational education. You can receive also badges for that on different levels. And then you can receive C-Education for free.
Maybe just move the browser to the Beamer so that we
can... Ah! Oops. Wo ist der jetzt hin? Kommt das rüber? Da ist es jetzt. That is the C-Explore program. You cannot read it here. But they provide a fundamental course, then concepts of the mainframe architecture and everything else, an advanced module and other things. I received yesterday also the hint we want to receive trainings for CVM. We have received, there's also the Academic Mainframe Consortium with monthly meetups. So we have got also a meetup group in Germany in this direction. And when we said we want to receive feedback, what we should add to these free courses. So on the right side above, if you have signed in with an account, you can send also emails to the team behind this C-Explore program and say, I want to have trainings in this direction for free. So use this C-Explore program for learning the foundations. There is also stuff for COS, for Linux foundations. But if you want to receive something additionally, write them, say we want to have additional courses in this direction and they want to add it. Yes, I can recommend also the Academic Mainframe Consortium. That's the way I have joined this community. They provide monthly meetings for new joiners in the direction of IBM. IBMers are providing presentations, T-Systems is providing presentations, Dativ is providing presentations, and then there is also the C-Talents community. They provide trainings for beginners with knowledge sharing between all the IBM customers. And yes, this education community is growing and growing in this direction. And you can receive also links to the main topics and what exists in this direction on the C-Systems wiki page of OpenSUSE. That is the most expanded website with training stuff. Where can you find something about architecture, videos in this direction and everything else? So I look, but I write all down what I can find and receive.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for joining.